Hi folks, back to oils. Done quite a few watercolours lately. This is my old tray to my Stay Wet palette. I've put a membrane on so that the paint doesn't stick to the plastic box. And a very limited palette, Cadmium Red, Ultramarine and Cadmium Yellow, Cadmium Yellow Pale. I've added Viridian because the scene I have in mind needs some really bright grass, and I'm basing this painting. Let's move that now, put it back on my side here. Well, I think you'll be able to see some of it. Still haven't got my new camera. It's been over a month now. It's been on order. Probably a lot of people bought Panasonic cameras before Christmas. I was watching TV last night and there was a superb photograph of a grass meadow, my one will be, with some trees on the horizon, but with these fucking dark grey storm clouds coming over it. So I'm going to have a go at that. I'll probably have to put out some Payne's grey, in fact I will, to help with the grey. That's my shortcut anyway. Here we are. Just a little bit of Payne's grey. I'll try and describe the colours as I go along. Probably need some yellow ochre on there as well, so we'll bung some artist quality yellow ochre out, only because I've got a tube of it. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 colours, but one is a Payne's grey, which I don't really count as a colour, it just helps out. Right, okay, so I'll put in the tree shapes first. So I've got a bit of liquin here in my palette. Liquin is fast drying flow medium for oils, beautiful stuff, Winsor & Newton. So let's just mark it out, a bit of green. Coming down there, so brilliant. Oh, that's why I wanted the Viridian, it makes a brilliant green. You can add some white to it to tone it down. There we are. Right, so let's clean the brush and we're going for some trees. Now the light is going to be behind this cloud, so I want this illuminated more than that side. So we've got a mix of primaries, blue, red and yellow. You've got a lovely, lovely, rich something like that. I'll mix a bit more yellow in here. So I've lined up those and these are in the cloud shadow. Right, okay, here we go. Let's do the sky. The fun bit. I'll use. Got a bottle. It's a beautiful day today. It's what we call a frost, cold, bright, frosty morning. Super. Lovely, lovely day in January. It's not warm. No, I've got a hoodie on and a bodyboard, well not bodyboard, but a Sherpa jacket that I got off of eBay. Right, let's put in some blue here and there. I picked up some of that, excuse me, that viridium. Done that. It'll dry and I can go over it. Well, it won't dry completely, it'll just go tacky. It's a bit of watercolour paper under one of my recent demos. If I could just get that bit off. It won't come off. Right, let's get some, just a basic sky at the moment. I might lift that horizon up a bit. Okay, right, here we go. Liquid, plains grey, let's try a bit of red and a bit of blue. And I'm not copying anything. Probably not the best grey, but I work on the all over the picture these days. When I first started oil painting, I do what everybody did, every beginner. You work to a finish. Bits of the painting, instead of flitting between the sky, say in this case the sky, they're sort of nearly dry there now. that went up a bit higher, that tree. So that's because we're trying to water it. Hair stuck in there. Let's get rid of that. Oops. Ah, got it. Right, I've got to do some modelling. Just sort of highlight another one there. Oops, lifting the paper, I'll be able to do that, don't we? Now, go over a bit of thick paint. Let it off a bit. Some ochre. What I wanted the ochre for, it's just to go to warm clouds. And what you don't want to do is make your clouds copy the trees. Common mistake I make, so you wouldn't be the only one. Yet. Dark. Now, to make the clouds darker, we've got to put in quite a bit of light. Well, coming on slowly. Right, let's get some light back in here. Well, going better. Nearly there. Let's just highlight some of this here. Right, get some blue in back in there. Well, I've done enough of that for a moment. Go back on those. No, I won't do the trees yet. I'm going to mix some yellow, some viridian, and white. There's two blue in there. Oh, yummy. Yeah. put a darker green there. Mix a bit of Payne's Cray with that mix. To stand for shadow. Go back to that brilliant green again. It's a touch of brilliant, touch of cadmium yellow, bit of white. Just see how bright that's and the lights in this now. Right, I gave the brush a good clean through my fingers. Go back to those trees and do a bit more of that sky. I'll change the brush because I've got too much green on that. Thank you. This isn't as easy as it looks. Change the shape of this a little bit. Alright, let's go back and do a little bit of work on the trees. So we want the green mixed with the three primaries. Yeah, I should be on the line. Right, so see if we can darken that a little bit. I don't know, that's gone wrong there. Because I mixed a bit of Viridian in accidentally. And when I finish this, I'll... So you get a lovely dark, but a great dark green. Right, just need to... That one's worked out all right. Right, that's good. A bit of Viridian white, and just to streak through here a bit. These scales aren't billowing really. So this is how I clean my brushes. Just pull them through. Don't be too fierce with them. You don't want to pull the bristles out of the ferrule, but just just do that. It takes out most of the oil until you get down to doing the big cleanup. Interesting. I'll bring some of that very light blue in. Transition there. All right, well, let's get in here. I'll call that a day. Well, not quite. I want to put in some little bits of indication of people. I've got this little, what was it? It's a number of Sterling Pro Art flat, long flat. I used these brushes when I was painting a lot of Venice paintings. A gallery. They were very good for doing the windows. Right, so a bit of white. Out on the links. Oh, my paint's gone dry now. Okay, just gives the eye something to latch onto this. I put that in a mound. It looks more or less like what I saw. The clouds were very, very difficult to model. Take those off. A bit of tape, just to clip it to the board so that it doesn't move in the room. Put the mounts on it. Let's put that there. Side. So it's handy. Using those clips, I get a bit of dry, unpainted stuff that will allow me to put the mounts on. The whole painting is drying quite fast. Now over there, put that one on. It's a bit small, actually. Put this big one on. Well, there we are. That's a painting. Let's see if I can just raise this up so that you can see the whole thing. Well, there it is. Got it on a slight hill, which was deliberate. Oh, it's not as dramatic as the one I saw on the TV, but I've got a bit of light around the top of the clouds, so to give the impression that the light is behind all the shadow here. Anyway, I'm quite pleased with that one. Hope you like it, folks. I'll get it uploaded for you and see you soon. Bye bye.